Jyoti Bhai, the Lalit Kala has been an institution in India that has served a purpose, especially early on in its in how it was founded and conceived, to be able to be a space of aid and intervention within a cultural space. And in its initial role, there were, I think, a lot of interesting people that were part of that organization. What was it like in those early years? What was the kind of participations that the Lalit Kala had, which allowed you all to engage with it? And then later, as we all know, as part of the kind of history, there were many times when artists felt the need to protest, to ask for the organization to change some of its systems. In the exhibition, we have actually photographs documented by you of those times of your friends and colleagues. So what is the kind of overview you have of what the Lalit Kala was? Definitely expectations and circumstances and situations where all of you were sort of asking for that change and that insistence for it to remain a faithful organization for the support of artists. And today it somehow seems like a sort of a dead area for art, or is it something that still holds a function that you believe helps artists? Because artists are not just who we see as the visible people. There are also many artists in many locations, in regional places. Mm. And we know that the Lalit Kala actually functions in regional, as a regional center for the development of art activities. So does it still hold a purpose?
I think it can hold a purpose. Lalit Kala was started, I think, in 1955 or so, first time. And started by Government of India, Department of Culture. And they had these three academies, one for visual art, which is Lalit Kala Academy, one for literature, which was Sahitya Academy, and one for performing arts. That time it was the only institution like that, which was national. So this there were societies like All India Art and Craft Societies and Bombay Art Society. They were in a way national, means anyone could participate. But mostly it became local. Bombay Art Society would have 75% works from within Maharashtra, 50% from Mumbai city itself, like that. Well, this was that way true national. And also, the people who were in charge, they were all appointed in beginning. They were less orthodox. So the like that Hussein's painting, one of his best works, Zameen, was exhibited in first exhibition, and it was also awarded prize. So it functioned that way. The main members were appointed, but they also had representatives from different states, because it was a national academy, and there should be people from different parts of India. So from 55 to 70, almost for 15 years, it worked in the same manner, smoothly. Then artists thought that we should have right to send our representative, because all people were appointed directly or nominated directly by Government of India. I mean, government is not a person, so somebody was actually involved in suggesting names. And all young people always think that older people are nuisance, so that was just basic psyche, I think. On the other hand, because they were old, because they didn't have anything what you say, personal agendas. No? Backward or not, they were honest. And they wanted to do something for younger people. No? So that kind of a feeling was there. But people thought that we should have some members whom we can send. You know? So that was the main reason for protesting.
Okay.
Also, that time, the people who were protesting had realized that there were some members from a certain area who were becoming more powerful and they were in a way maneuvering the other thing.
Mm-hmm.
Because though there were people like Kal Khandalawala and Mulk Raj Anand and many, they were kind of a gentleman. No? They would not shout, they would not go out of their way to do something. No, I mean, they would suggest. So the people who were actually loud mouth rather, or foul mouth perhaps, were becoming more powerful and they had started controlling certain things. So that this was known to people from Delhi, because that time we didn't have much gallery system or art market. Few works were sold somewhere in Bombay. Mainly, Delhi was the only area where people were selling work to either tourists or embassies and consulates. Yeah. And because they were changing their staff, this continued, and that's why many people moved to Delhi. So people in Delhi knew more about what was happening in Delhi than outsiders. And somehow other, it took little time, but they agreed and decided that there should be elected members. And method was worked out. In beginning, they had some members selected for a while. Then every 2 years they wanted few more, so it would rotate. But then the way it happened with our national politics, this became a mini
mafia itself.
Same. Yes. People knew how to get elected. Then they had made an electoral college. It was called who can vote.
Yes.
So whoever was given chance to, whoever had ever exhibited his or her work in academy, Lalit Kala Academy, national exhibition, can automatically be members. So few people who were teaching in Jaipur and some art school, they would take bus full of works. And the selection committee, it was almost like that, decided that you have to select these people. So eventually they had their own very large number of people who would vote for them. When it was the first election, I was also selected in this elected members. And people who got highest vote, 5 members, would continue for certain 10 years, not 10 years, just to make that rotation working.
Yes.
So I was even one of those 5. So I know how it worked. And by then, in 15 years, there were several academies had also come up, at state levels.
Right.
So members from each state level academy
on.
Was there. And so there were something like 60 members. So they knew how to manipulate, how to do this. One would suggest name of Manisab, Subramanian, who never wanted to be a member.
Sure.
I even said that we should ask him whether he wants to be a member or not before. So they said, in constitution it doesn't say anyone can nominate, anyone can second, and then there is, if necessary, election. They also worked out that nobody will vote for Subramanian, but and no, they decided that you must vote Mr. X. But people who would not agree to that giving vote, their vote will be wasted because Mr. Subramanian or whoever X would either never get elected
or accept.
But so they
doubt, yes.
And they had explained us later, because they were also friend, sitting on opposite side, but otherwise good friend, but more involved in that kind of things. That's how I learned to know what had happened. So eventually, I heard that this committee became so strong, because then they will have their own executive committee. An executive committee had right, according to constitution, to appoint secretary. So secretary will be under their hand.
Yes.
For 2 years. And they would never make him permanent. Every 2 years, new secretary was appointed. So committee could do anything. And then as people started blaming later, that they were actually taking commission for giving prize. That sort of thing.
So the corruption had really kind of seeped in, yes.
Now, there is always some exaggeration, I am sure. If they do not select my work, if they do not give me prize, I would think it differently. And if I get prize, I would think differently. But still,
Yes.
In fact, people like election, political election or cricket match, people knew beforehand who was going to get prize. And often,
it was
some
that,
totally yes. unexpected people got prize. Mm. So then there was some government committee and inquiry, and then it started breaking up. When they appointed good people as chairman, the committee could see that chairman was so harassed that he would almost run away. But it still functioned. For new people to come up. And getting an award in academy itself became kind of a degree, some honor.
Yes.
Yeah. I mean, because I had got prize when I was a student, that helped me to get not only job here, but number of scholarships. So something like this, it has helped a lot of young people in their beginning. And they all eventually left the interest in Lalit Kala Academy because... The function was already, it served their function beginning.
Yes.
Often putting our head under sand.
Yes.
We can't do anything to make it better, but at least we shouldn't be part of it. I mean, that kind of a escapism.
I had asked you in our conversation in the gallery, which was part of the exhibition, that there is a strong absence of photography in major collections that should have it. Because I think that we have had a resistance in India to acknowledge photography as being an art form. And you had mentioned, and I'd like to, maybe if you can recall that again, how... there was such a kind of narrow understanding of what the application of technologies to an artwork, and they had made these sort of rigid categories, believing that therefore by doing that, that was making pure art and higher art. And you had done something interesting to break into that, not because you wanted to cheat a system, but because you actually found it absurd, the manner. So I was interested to hear you talk about that, and to also to tell me what do you think that there's going to be a change in, say, places like the NGMA, and do we believe that photography is going to be something that is collected? Having the exhibition of X or Y or Z is fine, it's wonderful, and certainly should be. But I'm actually talking about recognizing that it is an art form that needs to be part of whatever is deemed as a national collection.
It should be. But, you know, the people have always resisted anything new. I mean, that's a general thing, no? Instead of accepting new thing, first reaction is no, 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 and then you start with but and it goes on. So when photography was invented, it was the same reaction. Another thing, people also find it easy when something is very difficult, and if people can do it, then it's accepted as something great, art or whatever else. If everybody can do something, then it loses the will, you know. So, so you have to be, I mean, different. Like, you know, our item songs, where 200 people are dancing, all of them are wearing black clothes, but hero will be wearing white. Or if all of them are wearing black, no, white, then hero will have black. No, then only, so something like this. Eventually, when so many people started doing photography, people lost that kind of interest, because first it was made with machine, not with hand. No. So credit was never going to artists. And then so many people were doing it. No. If there were 5 or 10 people, no. That's why photographs taken by Rajiv Gandhi, because he was prime minister, he was son of Indira Gandhi. People still accepted him as a photographer, or his work was noticed because of that background. But otherwise, no. In fact, everyone now today says same thing about the digital thing, and no, that now everyone can do it. But so what? No, I mean, it's nice that instead of only 1% or 10%, now everybody is, no. I don't have to be a son or daughter of Queen Elizabeth. But there is one difference which makes photography and painting different, you know, if we consider it as language. As I don't know, I mean, the way I see language has main function of language is communicating something with another. No? Yeah. That another person can be yourself also. No, you are still conversing sometime. But with verbal language, what happens is that I can tell you what I want to say. Mm. Or with the same language, I can understand and take it what you are telling me. No? I don't have to say anything.